So you might have been wondering, how do I use the difference quotient with fractions? Well, the simple answer is the same way you'd use it with any other type of function. But there is one small trick I'll show you that'll make finding the difference quotient for a rational function a whole lot easier. So now we know that this is the formula for the difference quotient. With any difference quotient problem, we really only need two pieces, f of x plus h and f of x. This second term, f of x, is just the function itself that we're given. This first term, f of x plus h, is whatever we get when we replace x with x plus h in our original function. And regardless of the type of function we start with, whether it's a fraction or not, we're still just looking for f of x plus h and f of x. But let's do an example where we find the difference quotient for a fraction, like the function 3 over x minus 2. Starting with the difference quotient formula, we can replace f of x with 3 over x minus 2, since f of x is always just the original function that we've been given. Now all we need is f of x plus h. So we'll replace x with x plus h everywhere in our original function, and we'll get f of x plus h is equal to 3 over x plus h minus 2. Now we can plug this into the difference quotient formula for f of x plus h. Up to this point, this is exactly what we do for any kind of function, regardless of whether or not the function is a fraction. But here's where the trick comes in. Once you get to this point, you need to start simplifying the difference quotient, but you've got what we'll call the little fractions inside the bigger fraction. It can be confusing to simplify fractions within fractions, but here's the trick to do it in one easy step. You want to find a common denominator for the little fractions. So the denominator of the first little fraction is x plus h minus 2, and the denominator of this second little fraction is x minus 2. The easiest way to find a common denominator is just to multiply these together. Don't feel like you need to multiply this out. The vast majority of the time, it really won't help you at all. Once you have this common denominator, you'll want to multiply both the numerator and denominator of the big fraction by that value. You can do that, of course, because when the numerator and denominator are equal, the fraction is equal to 1. So we're really just multiplying by 1, which of course doesn't change the value. So now we just need to do some distribution. When we multiply the common denominator by 3 over x plus h minus 2, it'll cancel out the x plus h minus 2, leaving us with just 3 times x minus 2. When we multiply the common denominator by the 3 over x minus 2, it'll cancel out the x minus 2, leaving us with just 3 times x plus h minus 2. And in the denominator, we get h multiplied by the common denominator. And just like that, you've eliminated the little fractions in one easy step. Now we can simplify the numerator by multiplying everything out and then canceling terms. Finally, we'll cancel out the h from the numerator and denominator. That'll be our final answer, and that's how you use the difference quotient with fractions. Could you use some extra help with math? Click the button to head over to calculusexpert.com. It's where I've collected and organized all of my best resources, including exclusive videos, notes, quizzes, and even formula sheets. It's the perfect resource whether you're struggling, or if you want to take your learning further, or even if you just want to save yourself some time studying. So check it out, because I know it'll help.